Hi guys, my name is Ferdy, and in this video series I will show you how you can work with all the Elementor Pro elements. In this video we will take a look at the flip box element. If you want to get Elementor Pro, then click on the link below in the description. And if you buy Elementor Pro through my affiliate link, you don't pay more, but I get a commission, so thank you for that. If you want to see the result of all the Elementor Pro elements, then go to elementor2018.com and go to the page Elementor Pro. Here I will show you all the elements, so let's get started. In the beginning I thought the flip box is something I will never use, and now it is my favorite element. So let me show you what we can do with the flip box. I can drag it over here to a new section. Now there is one big flip box. And when I saw this I was like, not that interesting. Let me duplicate this column 2 times. Let me start with this one. If I click on it, you have a front, you have a back, and you have the settings. If I go to the settings, I can change the height. For instance, I can say 220. We can have a border radius, make it a circle if it's possible. And then we have the flip effect. And you can change it to slide, so it will slide like that. Really nice. Or push. Zoom in. It's getting better and better. Zoom out. And the latest one, a really nice fade. If we take a look at the flip effect, then there's a really nice addition. Of course, you can change the direction, but you have also 3D depth, and I really like it. Right now, the flip looks flat, but if you turn on 3D depth, look at this. And maybe you don't see that well because we have a white background and white text. So let me fix that in the background of the section. I stretch this section, I make it full width, and I change the style to a gradient, maybe the same one as this one. Style. Let me grab this color and go to this section. Like that. Go over here again. Change the padding to 30 or 50. And no right and left, only the top and the bottom. I go back to this one, and now you see it. If you hover over it, you see the 3D effect better. We have the front. Here we can change the text. I can change the icon, for instance, to something else. And then we can change the heading. Heading. And here we have the text, and we can duplicate it. Like that. We can also change the background to gradient like that. Change the location, change the angle. We can do a lot of stuff. And if I hover over it, you see the other background. So then we can go to the back. And we have the heading, we can change it, and the text. Or we can just remove it. And I have a button over here, so I can also remove the title. And say click here, and then we can go to a certain link. And here we can also change the background. And maybe I want to have an image as a background. So I click on classic, image. I can grab something like this. Then you don't see a lot, you only see this area. So I can change the position to center, for instance. And I can also say size cover, like that. Then I can have a background overlay and make it a little bit transparent, like that. Now, if you, wherever you are on the website, you only see the back right now. So if I would click outside of this area, then you will see it in action again. A heading with a text and an icon, a nice background. And if you hover over it, you see a 3D flip. So that's really nice. What else can we do? If I go to this one, I click on it, and I go to the front. I don't want to have an icon, so I remove it like that. And I click over here and I say rent this house. I can have some text about the house, but I can also have a background about the house. So I click on classic and I want to have an image and I want it to be black and white. So I grab this image, I insert the media and you see nothing because we need to change the position. I think lower center, so bottom center. You see that. But also here, I want to say size cover. So you see the house. But now you don't see the text that good, so I go to background overlay, make it black, make it transparent. What I also can do, I can go to the settings and change the height to 500 pixels. Okay, that's better. And now it looks like that. I click over here again, I go to the settings, and I want to change the flip effect to fade. So now it looks like that. If I go to the back, I go to background over here, classic, and I upload an image again. I want it to be the colored one, which is this one. I insert the media and I need to configure it again. So bottom center, size, cover. If I click here, I see the flip box again in action. I hover and now it becomes like that. What I don't like is that I don't see the text. So I go to the back again, to the background. And also here, an image overlay, black and a little bit more transparent, but only a little bit. Now I go to the style and we can have some padding, for instance, 30 or 50. And that is for everything within this box. The alignment, everything can be aligned to the right or to the left or to the middle, but the vertical position can also be changed. So I bring it up in the sky of the background. So that's better, I think. We can have a border. You see it over here. 5 or 10. Change the color to black. But I don't want to have a border, so I say none, but you can have one. There's no icon, so we don't need to change that. The title, how much space between the title and the text. I think this is okay. I want the title to be a little bit bigger. Rent this house. And then the description is fine with me. I go to the back settings. And there I need to do the same. So I say 50, bring it to the center, bring it to the top. I search for the title spacing 13 and the size 26. This one I bring to 30. At the front also 30, 13, 26. I save it. I close this. And I need to change this text, so I go to content, back, rent this house, save, click away. So now it's black and white, and if I hover over it, it becomes color. You can click over here. If I go to the back again, I can change the text, rent this house, and then go to booking.com/house, something like that. Apply on the button or the whole box. So no matter where I click, if I click over here, I also go to that link. So I scroll down and I refresh. And there it is, the 3D one. And rent this house. Click over here, go to the back, background, and I want to clear this area. And now I want to go to style, to the back, and I change the color of the title to black. And the color of the text, description, text color, black. So if I put this off and I hover over it, it looks like that. The only thing you don't see is the button. So I go to the back of the style, scroll down, text color, and there we have the button style. Text color should be black. The border color should be black. And if you hover over it, you should see a greenish background. And white text and a white border. Maybe a little bit darker. So if I close this and if I hover over it, it looks like that. So you see there are so much options and I really like it. If I take a look now, refresh, you see it's set over the full width of the website. I like that. And I want to duplicate this one. So I hover over here. Let's see what happens. Okay, save it, refresh, and you can configure this on the pixel. So I want to align those. So how can I do that? I go over here, go to content, settings, and bring this back, 460, save it, refresh. And now they're perfectly aligned. I like it. I close this one, I duplicate this one, and I want to do one more thing. I want to add a graphic element, which is an image. I click over here, I search for Daniel, I click over here, and there it is. I want it to be full Daniel Lugo. I am an ambassador for compassion, something like that. Look at the projects I don't know, I'm just typing something. Then we can go to the style, to the image, make the image bigger, and I want to have a border radius. I want it to be round like that. I think that's okay. Now if I hover over it, you see that? I don't want that. So I go to the front of the, I go to content, background, and I want to grab an image of South Africa. For instance, this one, insert media. But what I want to do now, I want it to be aligned in the center. This time I want it to be, I still want it to cover, but I want the attachment to be fixed. Now if you scroll, you see the image is fixed on the background of this area. If I hover over it, it looks totally different, so I will fix it later. I think there can be a little bit less transparency or more. And then I go to the back, background. Same image. Fixed, covered in the center of the center. And I can change the text, of course. So I go to content, my portfolio, remove this text, have a button, portfolio, /portfolio, apply link on the whole box. Then I go to settings and I want to have the flip box again because I like that with the 3D effect. I want it to be go down. So now it looks like that. And I want to have my portfolio in the middle. So I go to style, back, have it in the middle. Change the color to white, and the color of the button also to white. Save it, refresh, and now we have this area only with flip boxes. Really nice. If you click on it, you go to portfolio. So that's it for the flip boxes.
Thank you for watching this tutorial. Please like this video, subscribe if you want to have more videos, and then I will see you next time. I wish you the best. Bye bye.